Everybody, welcome back to my channel. I just want to talk about the Disney news that is coming up right now. So what I know is Sleeping Beauty Castle is currently under refurbishment. And until later this spring. So, and the problem I think the problem is that the Mickey Mix Magic show, the nighttime show, the new nighttime show for this whole celebration of Mickey 90 years, is how are they going to put the projection on the castle? Because the fence is basically covered the whole, the middle half of the castle, but you can see the top half. So I'm guessing maybe, here's my solution is, they fix the castle during the daytime, but when the nighttime show is about to start, they like take the fence out. Put the analytics, then start the show. Because they're probably gonna just do projection on the Main Street USA. The laser, then put a projection on the fence, which is kind of weird because all the nighttime show is always the castle is always the front of the castle is always showing, and they put the projection on the show, and. And I got some information about it is for the celebration of Mickey 90 years is that it starts the debut of that nighttime show is this Friday. So and it will show at Rivers America where the Fantasmic show is always shown. It's a Small World. They're gonna show at the It's a Small World ride, and Main Street USA and the castle. And they said they'll have projection, laser, and fireworks. So they say addition of fireworks. So hopefully they do fireworks. I'm hoping they do fireworks. And then. They'll bring back the Mickey Sound Station Parade, and it'll debut on January 25th at Disneyland Park. And hopefully, it says Mickey Mouse will lead the way in a new, larger than life opening, inspired by classic Mickey pool toys. And Chip and Dale will arrive with a giant celebration cake. As Mickey Lee, a whimsical musical procession of Disney characters. So, if it's 90th birthday, right? Then they'll probably pull out 90 characters for this parade. That's what I'm thinking. Then Valentine's Month, it says, and this is by an article from Michael Ramirez. So give him a big time credit for. Towards this information. He's an editorial content director for the Disneyland Resort Company. Give him a big credit for this information. And Valentine's Month it says celebrate the love of Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse during Valentine's Month. Disneyland Park will feature lovely festive Valentine decor, including a new Mickey Mouse flower portraying Main Street USA. So guests like us, guests that are coming to visit Disneyland Park may also choose a partake in mini Valentine's surprise, a special scavenger hunt experience in Disneyland Park. Once guests have purchased a commemorative map and sticker at select merchandise location, they may search for a hidden Valentine's that Mickey has left for Mickey around the park. So this is just only for Valentine's So from January 22nd to just right, just day, couple days after Valentine's Day, February 18th is when it is done with this activity, festive ac Valentine's activity. And it says Valentine's, well, yeah, that's what I said. Then food and beverage, merchandise, and more specialty food. So for the 90th and 90th celebration, they'll have specialty food just to commemorate the celebration. And beverage, new, like new beverage, novelty items, and merchandise will be available for a limited time, including the classic Mickey and Minnie shaped food with a new festive twist. Exclusive Get Your Ears On themed treats. And Valentine's Prior specialty items. In addition, limited edition celebration merchandise will be available for all ages, including apparel, pin, plush, and of course Mickey and Minnie ears. So you can't yet have Mickey and Minnie ears. So that's some of the information. You go in. There's other information about more about the food. Where is it? Oh, here we are. So it says, you go to the link to the tweet from yesterday. It says, the tweet says, get a sneak peek at some of the specialty food and merchandise that will be available as part of Get Your Ears On a Mickey Mini celebration at Disneyland Resort. So, let's talk about it. Same person that the information is from the same person, Michael Ramirez. So, on the picture, you'll see a Mickey celebration hat, a celebration Mickey T-shirt with his face on it, a classic. Looks like a kind of a classic style Mickey hat with a bag that says "Let's celebrate." So, and it has Mickey and the castle on it. So, on the apparel of the shirt, T-shirt, baseball cap and clinch celebrate 90 colorful years with everyone's favorite mouse. Items are available in men's, women's, and youth size, so you can coordinate with your friends and family. Keep an eye out for other new merchandise, including, and I'm not sponsoring anything. This is all Disney. If you want to get Disney product, go to the Disney store in Downtown Disney, and then that's where it all is. And in the Disney park, DCA, it says keep an eye out for other new merchandise, including celebration drinkware, pins, plush, and of course, Mickey and Minnie ears. In Downtown Disney District, the Pandora store, the Pandora store in Downtown Disney is like, is if you is couple several doors several stores down, you keep walking past the one before you see the restaurant section. Will debut a limited edition Disney Dingle charm for 14 karat gold 90s. Dooney and Brooks will feature a new Mickey Mouse bag, and a special Mickey Through the Years dress will be available at the Disney's dress shop in Downtown Disney. I didn't see it when I was there this past summer. And it was in the food. It says there will be a whole host of eats and treats celebrating our favorite pal, ranging from specialty churros, which we all love churros. You gotta have churros. Churros are really good. Like the this past summer, it was Pixar Fest, so we got Senor Buzz Churros, and that was really good. Then we had the, then they still had the classic churro. The classic churro is always the best one. Buzz churro is like a little bit spicy, and they have like Jack Jack Num Num cookie, which they will still, which they still have, since they have the Incredicoaster kept, like they're still there. They're not taking it down. It's going to be there forever. And it says, Mickey beignets to get your ears on funnel cake, fries, and special celebration cake. On the savory side, you can chow down on unique items like share your cheeseburger. So in the picture of the cheeseburger, there's one big cheeseburger and two small cheeseburgers. Kind of like, not really this small, but like this small. As ears, they represent Mickey. And then like cheeseburger sliders, that's one. Or the spectacular Mickey cheesy pizza with Mickey pepperoni and confetti of peppers and onions. So that the all of the food that on this picture is really good. And yeah, that's why they're gonna have limited time from January 18th of next week, this coming week, to whenever this celebration ends, which is probably in September. Usually when like a big celebration deal and it's close to ending, they probably extend it like another month or so, just because let people experience the celebration. Like Disney Diamond Celebration, the 60th anniversary. So it was from the, where is it from? It was from May to August. Then they extended just a little bit of a month to September so that people can get a chance to experience the celebration. And I'm telling you, I've been to Diamond 60 in Pixar Fest, and it's awesome. So this one is probably even more awesome. And other news is that they closed down It's a Small World ride for a little bit so they can clean up, take the Christmas decoration out inside the ride, and put the original in there. Haunted Mansion, same thing. They taking down Nightmare Before Christmas special of in the Haunted Mansion to put in the regular to transform to the regular Haunted Mansion. The ride bef okay, so you so let me describe this right. It has a rocket that goes around and around. It's the entrance of Tomorrowland. So that ride is closed down for refurbishment as well. Sleeping Beauty Castle is closed. The walkthrough into the inside the castle is closed as well until this late spring. The others are opening soon. DCA, there's a couple of Grizzly Bear Rapids is closed for refurbishment. One other ride is, I think it's closed. I don't know the name of it, but and one of the restaurants is closed, but it's opening soon, so that's good. And I think that's it for in Disneyland about this for Disneyland news. And Disney World is doing some other things. They're doing and they're oh yeah, so they're opening Star Wars Galaxy Edge at Disneyland Park, the big land ever at Disney Park, opening in the summer, and Disney World is opening in the fall. in at this, so let's shift it to Disney World. Epcot is having a new nighttime show. It's called Epcot Forever, and it'll have projection, fireworks, lasers, all that stuff that we that make the show great. At the Disney Hollywood Studios, they're having a new show called Wonderful World of Animation, I think, something like that. And it's like 30th anniversary of the park, and they'll have like shows of. They have projection, and I think they didn't go into. Let me see. I know they have projection, but I wonder if they have. They're gonna have fireworks or something, in with that show. Okay, so as I look through it, another news is that Disney Coronado Springs Resort is opening the new is a new hotel. Okay, so they're gonna still do illumination for right now until they get ready. So for right now until they get ready for the following year, because the following year, 2020, is when the Epcot Forever debuts. I don't know what month it is, but sometime in 2020. Okay. If you go to the tweet from November 18th, 2018, says night the new nighttime spectacular attraction update, resort news and more were part of the hashtag Destination D fun this week. Click the link and it talks about Star Wars Edge, the video of it. The Disney Lakeside Lodge is a new hotel that has 900 rooms. It is coming to to Orlando, Florida. The Remy Ratatouille ride is coming to Epcot, and they're actually building that ride, I think, right now, and they're building the Guardian of the Galaxy ride. This one's a roller coaster. It's not the one that goes up and down. This, it's under construction right now as we speak. Okay, so though it's called the all new cinematic nighttime experience, the new show at Hollywood Studio. Disney Hollywood Studio in Orlando is called Wonderful World of Animation, which will debut in May 2019, this coming May, as part of the 30th anniversary celebration. So, for the, of that part, and it has There's news for the Mickey Minnie Runaway Railway. I think that's for Disney as well. Disneyland Park only. That's so, and like they're doing a. That's so far I know about Disney World. Haven't been there in quite some time. So far I've been to more of Disneyland the past two times. Last year, 2015, and maybe this year as well. And I like Disneyland. I like Disneyland. This just because it's like it feels home. It's classic. Disney World's big and like it's modern. It's more modern. Like there's more news about Disney World than it is Disneyland for me. Because every commercial of a Disney park, it goes from is Disney World, I think, than it is Disneyland. I'm not really sure, but that's fine. I like Disney World as well. I haven't been there since 2013, and that and right they have like they already have new nighttime show, Happily Ever After, which is. Looks like I already watched some videos of it. It looks amazing, looks magical, and it has like new projection, new they have laser, they have fireworks in there, and like yeah, it looks great. That's one on my bucket list, but right now it's like Disneyland, just because Disneyland is like they're gonna have there's new stuff there like. If you haven't been to DCA recently, which hopefully you guys have, they have the new Incredicoaster, they have the new Pixar Pier, they have like when and new restaurants, and it's you know it's it looks great. They're gonna build. They're finishing up. When I was there, they're still. They had like, they're building the carousel right next to a Incredicoaster, and like if you keep walking down, where Toy Story Mania is, they're doing some construction there, but it should be already finished by now, I think, because last time I came, it was late June, late mid June. Mid-June or late June, I was there. And it's already January, so it should be already close to be finishing up over there with the Tangle, the not Tangle ride, the Inside Out ride. They have like these arcade things, which by the way is not yet to actually pay to play those, I think, if I remember correctly. And like, yeah. This celebration Mickey is all over every Disney park. Disneyland Paris, Disneyland Hong Kong, Tokyo, and I think Shanghai as well is celebrating. I'm pretty sure because it has to be because they're Disneyland Park as well, Disney. So I'm pretty sure. Haven't been to Disneyland Paris, which I'm. Hopefully coming this August, I think, because my family and I are planning to go to Denmark. Hopefully. Not sure about that. It's in the air. But hopefully I get a chance. Now I'll have three more to go. Which it's kind of, I don't know if I can do it, but because the language barrier is kind of different, and it's kind of. If I said maybe, can I go? Do you know where Shanghai Disneyland is? And they probably know English a little bit, but it's like, it's It's gonna be a little bit difficult. And yeah, and other news is also the Oscars. So the Oscar doesn't have a host this year, and they're heavily reeling in, trying to reel in every Avengers cast to host the Oscar because they're a huge cast. There's there's 20 something heroes, I think. I'm not really sure. Pretty sure. And they can probably release the trailer during the Oscars. Probably like the end or the middle, one of those parts. And maybe Robert Downey Jr. should start as the host. There could be three. Maybe the first award goes as Robert, Chris Hemsworth, Chris Evans together, the three core, then the other core and the other another. Cause I remember back then, I think, I don't know, it was 2000, was it 2012, I think, is when they had in the Oscar, it was Robert Downey Jr., Mark Ruffalo, Jeremy Renner, Samuel L. Jackson, and I think Chris Evans was in there thinking. And they were at the Oscar, and I think they were, I don't know, they're hosting, but they were doing something. Maybe they can do like that. 3-3-3. One group does one award and the other and the other another. And maybe they come together and they release that trailer. Because I think that's the perfect time. Because February 24th is when the Oscar is. And it's two full months away. Because April 26th is when the movie comes out. And the trailer is, if it comes out that night, is because Captain Marvel is coming out in early May, early, not May, March, early March. So hopefully you guys like my information, my Disney news information. So if you are thinking about going to Disneyland, Disney World, that's all that's so far what the news is about. I'm concerned with the nighttime show at Disneyland just because I'm wondering they're probably gonna do projection on the castle, but I'm not sure how it's gonna work, but I trust in the Disneyland team, Disney company team, figuring out how to put the projection on the castle. And they will have fireworks and no news about the world caller show at DCA. It's been shut down for quite some time because they were doing refurbishment as well. So I'm not really sure when that's coming to open. And they're probably gonna have a new show, just like Fantasmic, while a couple of years back when they were trying to change some things of the show. So yeah, so hope you guys like this video. Hit the thumbs up button to like that if you like this video. Subscribe to my channel. Hope you guys have a great day, and I probably will see you this Friday to react to the new nighttime show at Disneyland Park on Friday. And yeah, have a great day, everybody.